So this is a looking back episode. We landed up at Dhaka last week.
It was the first time for both of us.
And we had our own expectations.
The ride from the airport to the hotel took 45 minutes.
It dismantled quite a few myths that we had come with.
Right. To start with, the roads. They were so smooth, wide, and then the density of traffic that we had expected. It was nowhere close to that.
At that time, yeah.
But what I didn't expect was all kinds of corporate entities welcoming each and everyone to the World Cup, as well as the general level of buzz that was around. It was simply not seen in India. This was just at a different level. And then all of a sudden, we find this moving cage, this green moving cage.
which is the auto rickshaw which is barred from all sides. The driver is barred, literally. And later we found this was done to prevent the passenger from mugging the driver. And what an effective solution, because apparently it's worked big time.
Correct, except good luck catching one that's empty.
So then we reach our hotel, the expansively named Grand Prince Hotel.
I would have expected at least the service to measure up.
The service, I didn't have a problem with the service because there was no lack of effort.
Sure, but the facilities also didn't measure up.
Yeah, well, the rooms were very pokey and there was no sunlight in the rooms, which is a very, very big deal for me. But okay, there were compensations. It's close to the ground, 10 minutes away.
Which is why we were completely surrounded by almost the entire media contingent that
Indian,
came to this
Indian contingent, yeah.
And all of them were there at the press conference. The 14 captains then make their grand appearance. And only two of them made opening statements. Ricky Ponting as the current holder of the cup and Mahendra Singh Dhoni.
As the future holder of the cup.
I guess.
No jingoism there. It's just pure practical rationale.
Yeah, right. We'll see about that. But Dhoni was delightful.
I particularly like that question that was asked of the Bangladesh captain.
Whether there was too much heat on them to win the opening match, and then Dhoni interjected and asked, why not the World Cup?
He smiled at, he and Graham Smith had a bit of a smile there. It was really nice. And I believe some Bangladeshi journalists did not like that, I think.
Yeah, later on the bus back from the conference, one of the local reporters told me that Shakib did not take that very well. I don't know how much it's true, but...
Yeah, but I think that's being thin-skinned, which we subcontinentals...
If it is the case.
Yeah, if it is the case. But I think we subcontinentals are very good at being thin-skinned.
It was just an innocuous joke.
It wasn't even a joke. I think what Dhoni was trying to say is that if you can beat India in an opening game, who are the favourites? Why the hell should you think that you can't win the World Cup?
The high density population of Dhaka really hit us when we stepped out at night.
Despite the crowds, the high density population, the feeling was not overbearing.
Right.
Overpowering.
Right. And it was a throwback to the 80s India.
Of which this was a great example. People watching a game outside a television store. And I mean,
it wasn't even a Bangladesh match. And it wasn't even a real World Cup match, it was just a practice match.
Between India and I think New Zealand, right?
Correct. Maybe this innocence comes from a lack of entitlement. And I hope that innocence stays and doesn't go the way it's gone in India, although the signs surely seem to be there.
I think for the first time in my life, my knowledge of Bengali had a practical application here, and there were actually people who were not, couldn't speak Bengali, who actually depended on me.
Right.
To
and I can vouch for that. It was an overwhelming experience for me to see how much I was dependent on knowing the local language.
And the people were that much nicer. Maybe it was a language thing, but I think they were nicer. They were nice generally. The one thing that stands out for me as far as Dhaka is concerned is the density of population, which particularly comes out after the sun has gone down. And you know, there must be something that makes these people, that changes the way these people feel, and the energy that gets dissipated with the amount of time it takes in traffic, how to get from one place to another, and it must make an impact on their day-to-day life.
Right, but despite all these hardships, one gets the feeling that people just carry on with their lives.
Like this shop, for example.
There was no power just in this one shop, and still they were carrying on as if it was business as usual.
They were working under candlelight without blinking an eye, and somehow one just feels that this is the ethos of Bangladesh, whatever we experienced in 5-6 days, and I think we look forward to coming back here.
Yeah.